Hello everyone, I am Sudhanshi Sharma from Shiveshno Institute of Forensic Science. My topic is precaution and goals of cyber forensic investigation. So let's start. First is cyber forensic, cyber crime, types of cyber crime, goals of incident response, precaution, cyber crime and precautions. First is cyber crime. Computer and computer network are used as a tool or a target or a place of criminal activity. The effect of cybercrime can be extremely upsetting for victim and not necessarily just for financial reason. Victim may feel that their privacy has been violated and that they are powerless. Unfortunately, as world reliance on technology grows, the cost and incident of cybercrime is expected to increase. The cyber forensics. The scientific examination and analysis of digital evidence in such a way that the information can be used as evidence in a court of law. The types of cybercrime: hacking, phishing, software piracy, cyber stalking, denial of services, financial crime, forgery, and cyber defamation. Goals of cyber forensic investigation. First is to confirm whether an incident has occurred, to promote accumulation of accurate information, educate senior management, help in detection, prevention of such incident in the future, to provide rapid detection and containment, minimize dispersion to business and network operations, to facilitate for criminal action against perpetrators, allow for criminal or civil action evidence, provide accurate report, useful recommendation, protect your organization and reputation and assets, establish control for proper retrieval handling of evidence. The six steps of response: pre-incident preparation, detected incident, initial response, investigation the incident, reporting and resolution. The handling of evidence by cyber analysis: identify, control, observe and preserve, analyze and organize and verify. Four major tasks for working with digital evidence. First, identify any digital information or articles that can be used as evidence. Collect, observe and preserve the evidence. Analyze, identify and organize the evidence. Repulse the evidence and or repeat a situation to verify the same result every time, checking the hash value. Cybercrime and precaution. Keep an eye out for phony email messages. Things that indicate a message may be fraudulent are misspelling, poor grammar, out of phrasing, website address with strange extensions, website addresses that are extremely numbered where there are normally words and anything else out of the ordinary. Second is additionally phishing messages will often tell you that have to act quickly to keep your account open, update your security or you to provide information immediately or else something bad will happen. Don't take the bait. Second, don't respond to mail messages that ask for personal information. Legitimate companies will not use email messages to ask for your personal information. When in doubt, contact the company by phone or by typing in the company web address into your web browser. Don't click on the link in the message as they might take you to a fraudulent miscellaneous websites. Sites clear of fraudulent websites used to steal personal information. When visiting a website, type the address directly into the web browser rather than following a link within an email or install message. Fraudsters often force this link to make them look conversing a shopping, banking or any other website having sensitive information should have an S after the letter. The S stands for secure and should appear when you are in an area requesting you to log in or provide other sensitive data. Another sign that you have a secure connection is the small lock icon in the bottom of your web browser, usually the right hand corner. Pay attention of privacy policies on websites and in software. It is important to understand how an organization might collect and use your personal information before you share it with them. Guard your mail addresses. SVIFS and phishers sometimes send millions of messages to email addresses that may or may not exist in hopes of finding a potential victim. Responding to those messages or even downloading images ensure you will be added to their list for more of these some messages in the future. Also, be careful when posting your email addresses online, in news group, blogs, or online communities. Online officers that look too good to be true usually are only texts. The old saying, there's no such thing as a free lunch, still ring true today. Supposedly free software such as a screen spent or smiley secret investment tricks sure to make your untold fortune and contest that you have surprisingly won without entering are the ethnic hooks used to buy companies to grab your attention. Review bank and credit card statement regularly. The impact of identity theft and online crimes can be greatly reduced if you can catch it shortly after your data is stolen or when the first use of your information is attempted. One of the easiest way to the tip of that something has gone wrong is by reviewing the monthly statement provided by our bank and credit card companies for anything out of the ordinary. Choose a strong password and keep them safe. Selecting a password that cannot be easily guessed is the first step toward keeping password secure and away from the wrong hands. Strong passwords have 8 characters or more and use a combination of letters, numbers, and symbols. Avoid using any of the following as your password. Your login name, anything based on your personal information such as your last name and words that can be found in the dictionary. Try to select an extra strong, unique password for protecting activities like online banking. Keep your password in the safe place and try not to use the same password for every service you see Use online. Change password on regular basis. At least every 90 days. This can limit the damage caused by someone who has already gained access to your account. If you note something suspicious with on one of your online accounts, one of the first step you can take exchange your password. Thank you.